that are featured in this book, which Martin Gill is the proud publisher of, American Quilt Treasures. It's recently come out, and what it's got inside of it are 67 American-made quilts from the collection here at the International Quilt Study Center. So those 67 American Quilt Treasures are in this book, and that's what we published. But what started the singular fascination discussion was really Carolyn and I think maybe Jonathan was in the room for part of this. I kept coming back to the fact that there are about 14 quilts in the book, unintentionally, that all feature a single shape being repeated. And I had the distinct honor and opportunity to look at all these quilts laid out on the tables, and I would say we probably shot 4 quilts in an hour's time by the time we folded it and refolded it and the team brought new quilts out. So I had 15 minutes with each of the quilts in this book to sit there and look at them and to put my hands behind my back and not touch them and to just fight every fiber of my being that was like, oh, I just want to hit it. I just want to touch it. Because that's what we are, right? As makers, we are so moved. But I said to Carolyn, as we kept looking at them, I don't know what it is about these quilts with a single shape, but they just speak to me. There is something so amazing to me that it's not as if someone had a pattern and was like, okay, the triangle goes here, you have to rotate the darks and the lights to go there. They operated with a single shape, a single square, a hexagon, a rectangle, a sliver, whatever that single shape was, and they turned it into something. And I think about the way I am a quilter, and I think about the way I design quilts that I'm working on, or my friends who make quilts. And I think about how many of them are fortunate enough to have a design wall, that you can step back and look at your work and you can put it up there and it's on flannel or it's on a tablecloth turned backwards, or you stand up on your second floor and you look down at the floor on your first floor. I know some of you are laughing because you're like, oh yeah, I've done that. But you're getting as far away. And then, like we all have this, right? Now we can take a picture of our quilt before we put it together. And we can look at it and go like, not sure that orange square needs to be there. I think that should be turned the other way. But the quilts that you're going to see in this exhibit are not quilts that were made at a time when anybody had a phone to take a picture of it. And likely no design wall. And if you're sitting there with that small hexagon, or that little yo-yo, or that square, and you're working on it in your lap, and you're piecing it together by hand, how do you know what that